All right, welcome to Astro Einstein. Hi, I'm Astro Einstein, and welcome to my channel. Normally, we speak on astrological stuff, but because I've been reading tarot for quite a bit, about 20 years, I'm going to do tarot readings based upon the sun and the moon sign. Example, I just did a video on the sun in Aries, moon in Aries. This video is about sun in Aries, moon in Taurus. We're going to do a series of moon and sun placements in the tarot directly connected to it. So if you like what you're hearing, just click the like button, subscribe, and tune in for the next video. Thank you for joining in. So we're going to focus on the sun in Aries, moon in Taurus. Now, if you don't know your moon sign, I'm gonna click a link to the bottom that is going to take you to finding out what your moon sign is, okay? If not, what you can do, there are a lot of apps that you can take and download on your phone or, you know, on your PC. But also there's website like Cafe, Astro Cafe, cafeastro.com, sorry about that. And they will take you to a birth chart where you will get to see exactly what your moon sign is. Now, we're going to get messages for sun and Aries, moon and Taurus. Sun and Aries, moon and Taurus. Okay. Sun and Aries, messages for sun and Aries, moon and Taurus. And this is for the month of July. So we're going week for week. All right, already is looking interesting for you guys. Take a look at, right, beautiful oracle cards. Oh, whoa, that is crazy. I shuffled these cards and for some apparent reason, some of the cards from Aries Sun, Aries Moon came up again. So anyway, for the first week in July, the Page of Pentacles showed up. When the Page of Pentacles shows up, this represents an idea, a business idea, a business opportunity. What I'm seeing, especially from the rest and rejuvenation, a combination of that, is that this month you need to have to take some time for yourself. And upon doing this, you're gonna be presented with a business opportunity. So don't feel as if you have to be the hustle and bustle as most people do. Since we're inside our homes, most of us, for COVID-19, this is showing that by doing the opposite of what most people are doing, you're gonna be presented with this business idea or this way of making money from on the inside. This week for you speaks volumes of taking the time for yourself, rejuvenating, and then going back into what you want to do. You know, this could be a creative endeavor, how you make your money. The Page of Pentacles doesn't necessarily restrict anything beyond just money. The Page of Pentacles is about the grounding, or feeling a sense of security. It brings a sense of security, news of security. And what I'm feeling is that by you being home, that some business opportunity or a job or some money venture is going to come to you. Just take your time, relax at home, and don't go crazy this week. because it's not going the way you expected. All right? Taking a look at the second week. And in your second week, it's showing a spiritual growth, a spiritual strength. But next to this is the reverse devil card, as you can see. Reverse devil card. And whenever I get that card, especially reversed, it means that all that obsession and sexual tension and feeling controlled, whatever that was that had you, is going to lose its grips. From the symbology of the card and what's on the card, you're going to see that there are two people chained. But when upside down, those chains fall off. Which means that there is a connection with somebody who you've been obsessed with. There's a controlling situation. Something that has been bothering you. It's going to bother you. But this week, that feeling will be gone. The reason why I feel that way is because of the spiritual strength card, which represents going within oneself and focusing. So this week, the second week, by focusing on the inner part, the things that have kept you feeling controlled and got your obsession, should dwindle away if you focus on, you know, the inner part of you, okay? So the second week, and let's take a look at exactly, we want to get clarity of exactly what that's about. Right. And I got the Three of Cups and the Ace of Wands. And this could be something of a ceremony, a party. It could be something that is connected to celebrating with a family member, a friend, or a loved one. Maybe you feel controlled by the circumstance of either, you know, helping out with a party or helping out with a celebration of some form of fashion. Well, according to this, that responsibility is going to be released for you. The Ace of Wands next to it represents, you know, creative endeavor. And by releasing the creative endeavor, this is also in connection with, you know, some form of party or a get-together. Don't feel compelled. Allow yourself to just stay focused. And the universe will take its course. Okay. The third week, what I see is the Queen of Cups. And the Queen of Cups normally represents that scorpion energy. That energy that's, you know, mothering but also very protective. And the card that clarifies it is movement, choices, and decision. Now what I see is a sort of a Scorpio friend or a loved one or a mother or some female energy is going to help you with some form of choices, some movement that you're supposed to be making. And what I'm getting from my intuition is this person is going to help you with either deciding on relocating or deciding on a class that you're supposed to take. Also deciding on, you know, very important decisions in your life, especially at the third week. Again, they got clarification cards for that. And it's showing King of Wands and the Wheel of Fortune. And the King of Wands as a clarification card shows that there's also a male figure also connected to it. This could be a father figure, you know, male figure that's also going to give you an opportunity, some form of, you know, fortune. So the Wheel of Fortune only represents, you know, karma, what goes around, comes around, what you've done, what you've put into it, you're going to get. And what I'm getting from my intuition is saying that you're going to have a decision on what you are going to be doing when it comes to either your schooling or your career or movement. Meaning moving or relocating. All right, that's the third week. And the fourth week of July shows the Moon card upright. And the Moon card represents, you know, secrets, but also represents family. It represents the inner essence of yourself, the things that you keep hidden away. And the card that is above it is the patience in planning. So the fourth card, or the fourth week of July, presents you with a sort of a planning with the family. You know, a get together, an outing of some sort. But either which way, it's showing a time of patience, getting together. Maybe you're gonna experience a family get together. Maybe, you know, family members are gonna come over and you're just gonna spend that time of just focusing, thinking about the past, reminiscing. All these things are connected to the fourth week of July for you. All right? Now I'm gonna pull a card for the overall reading. And the card of deception and envy showed up as the overall card. And what I'm getting from that card isn't necessarily you're gonna be deceived or deception, but what I'm getting is that what you will go through can be somewhat of a, what's the word I want to use? I'm fishing for the word. You're gonna help me with that. Smoke and mirrors, which means that I don't want you to deceive yourself. Don't try to do things that you necessarily won't do naturally. You know, when you're going to family members, don't force anything. Because what will happen is there'll be some sort of envy or jealousy. You try to present yourself as, yeah, I got this money when you're family, and I got this and I got that. Try not to push yourself so that people will receive you in a way that would make them want to envy you. Because then, you know, deception follows after. All right? I hope I was helping you. And if you like and it resonates with you, there's the like button there. And if you want to get further, you know, videos on your moon and sun sign, because this is a video for the sun in Aries and moon in Taurus. Thank you for tuning in. Hope to see you on the next video. Enjoy.